Excellent. All right. Let's go ahead and get started. So make sure that you have a clear space. You're not going to step on anything, trip on anything. Hopefully everyone has water. Let's roll the shoulders back and push them down, and then abs are in tight, right? Arms out in front, fingers spread wide, and arms side and feet back, or arms back and feet back. So they can go like this, or they can go like this, whichever you prefer. I hope everybody's awake. Good, and four, three, two, arm side, toe side. Remember, go at your own pace. Just try to keep moving. And if you need to alternate between your arms and your legs, that's fine. Or alternate arms even. Good. How about four, three, arms front, heels front. All right, so abs are in tight. Sometimes we just have to keep reminding ourselves. Good. And let's go back to feet back. And this time we're going to pull the elbows back. So here. Try to pinch those shoulder blades together. Let's turn that toe back into a heel raise, like you're kicking yourself. And if you can kick yourself, I'll be really impressed. Abs in tight. Good. Four, three, two. Let's slow it down. Let's knee up, biceps curl. Knee up, biceps curl. Knee up. Remember, if you need to put a hand on the chair or the wall, that's fine. Or maybe just barely pick your foot up. You can just pick your heel up too and leave your toes on the floor. Four, three, two, last one, let's march. Good, get those arms moving and the legs moving. Good, march out wide. March back in. March out wide. Good, march back in. March out wide. March back in. Let's do it one more time. March out wide. And march back in. Right, keep marching. See if you can roll your shoulders forward. And then roll them back. Good. Good job. Shake them out a little bit. Let's bring the hands up here and go knee up, knee up, knee up, knee up, knee up, knee up. And if it's too much to lift the knee, just lift the heel. Try to turn, turn. Turn, 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 turn. If you're sitting, make sure you come out toward the front of the chair. Four, three, two. We're gonna step forward, punch forward. So step and punch, step and punch, step and punch, step and punch. Try to really get that arm to move. Four, three, two, turn the punch into an uppercut. So up, 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 just march. Good, and slow it down a little bit. Very good. All right. We're going to balance again, but we're going to balance with our eyes open. So we're going to start with a tree pose. Pick a leg to start on. Doesn't matter which one you start with. But remember, you start with your toes on the floor and your heel against the inside of one ankle. Right fingertips light on the chair or the wall. And then if you're feeling pretty steady here, bring your foot up against the inside of your calf. Right? And if you're feeling pretty steady here, you can bring that foot all the way up. Just try to make sure that it's not on the inside of your knee. Right? Because we don't like to press directly on our joints. Whoa. Abs in tight. Find that non-moving focal point. And remember, you're not going to stand still like a statue. Yikes. Breathe and really focus. Abs in tight, shoulders relaxed. Find that non-moving focal point. Try to relax the toes of the foot that you're standing on. Good, and then go ahead and carefully set that foot down. Shake out both legs. Good, okay, and let's switch sides. So take your time, abs in tight, chin down, but neck extended. Right, shoulders back and down. When you're ready, if you feel that you can take your foot up off the floor. And then if you want to bring it up all the way, if you're feeling pretty steady, then go ahead and do that. Put your hands wherever they're more comfortable. Fingertip on the chair or the wall if you need it. Hands on your hips if that feels more comfortable. Breathing. Breathing is always helpful. So just a few more seconds. Good work, and release, and shake them out. Do a few leg swings forward and back if you need to. Very good. All right, going back to that first leg. This time, instead of doing the tree pose that we just did, we're gonna stand on one leg. If you need to, balance your toes on the floor. Right, but relax your shoulders back and down, abs in tight, stand up tall, try to find that non-moving focal point. If you're picking up your foot, do it here. Right, and breathe. Long, deep breaths. We're shooting for 30 seconds and we're at 15. Good work, everyone. 5 seconds more. We can do it. Abs in tight. Good job. Set that foot down. Ooh, shake them out. Ooh, not so easy, but it's a great way to build strength and stability. Stability is very important. All right, so same thing, other leg, shoulders back and down, abs in tight, up tall, find that focal point. And 3, 2, 1, pick your foot up. Remember, it doesn't have to be all the way up so that your knee is at hip level. Anything off the floor is great. And if you feel that you need to put your toes back down on the floor, then put your toes back down on the floor. And breathe. Good, 5 seconds more. Good work, everyone. And release. Go ahead and pick a leg, swing it forward and back a few times. And the other leg. Good job. Shake them out a little. Okay. So let's kind of sort of leave our legs alone for a little bit. So grab a set of light weights. Okay, we're going to start here. Right, light weights. And we're going to do just what we did in the warm-ups. So we're going to go step and punch, except we're going to alternate sides. Okay, so shoulders back and down, abs are in tight. And here we go. Step and punch, step and punch, step and punch, step and punch, step and punch. Good. Take your time. Well, don't exactly take your time, but do go at your own pace. Push, push and pull that arm, push and pull. So if it's too much to do the arm and the leg, just do the arms. Good. Four, three, two, one. Good job. Lower your arms down, roll your shoulders, shake them out a little bit. We're going to bring the hands up here. Right, and just like we did in the warm up, we're gonna pick up the heel and pull the elbows back. Okay, so the feet can be a little bit wider apart. Try to relax your grip on the weights, right? And here we go. Heel lift, pinch back, pinch back, pinch back, pinch back, pinch back. Pull, pull. Pull. Remember too, if you want, you can just shift your weight side to side if lifting the heels is too much. Four, three, two, one. Good job. Let's go ahead and set these weights down. Right. And again, loosen up the shoulders, roll them forward, roll them back. So your heart rate should be a little bit elevated. That's a good thing. We like that. Go ahead and grab a drink if you need one. Very good. All right, let's grab our tube or band. Okay, we're gonna shorten it up a little bit, right? But we're not wrapping it around our hands. Right, arms are gonna come out in front. If you're using weights, make sure that they're pretty light or even just your body weight. Okay, so no legs this time, just the arms. We're gonna go out and in. So we wanna try to bring that band out to about chest level and get those arms all the way out. Try not to make it a bending and straightening of the elbows. Right, the arms are staying pretty straight. Three more, we can do it. Three, two, last one. Good job. Lower the arms down, roll those shoulders forward a time or two, and roll them back. Very good. All right, we're going to drop one handle down on the floor, or one end, sorry, and we're going to step on it with one foot, and we're gonna hold the handle the other side in the opposite hand. So I'm stepping with my left foot and I'm holding the other end in my right hand. Right, up tall, abs in tight. We're gonna lift it up, down, up. Try to keep that arm straight out from the shoulder. It wants to come forward, the arm, because that's easier. Right, try to make sure that you're not doing this or you're not leaning back. And if it's too much, then just do it without the tube or band. Right, try to keep that arm straight out from the shoulder. Two more on this side. One more time. Good job. Switch that handle in, or the end into the other hand, and then roll that shoulder forward, back, shake out the arm a little bit. And we're gonna switch sides, but you already knew that. right? So make sure that you're stepping pretty close to the end if you're using a tube or a band, right? And abs are in tight. And then we're gonna lift, lower. Make sure that shoulder stays down away from your ear. Try not to grip the end or the handle too tightly. Breathe. And remember, no leaning to the side or leaning back. Abs in tight. Three more, you can do it. Three, two, last one. Good job. Put the handle in the other hand or the end. Roll that shoulder forward. Roll it back. Very good. All right, we're gonna pick it up again. We're gonna really shorten it and then go back to that first side that you did. So I'm doing my right side first. So my left hand is coming against the front of my shoulder and my elbow is staying down. My right elbow is coming up and then I'm gonna go out and in. Out and in. Yeah, so try to make sure that that arm again is staying in line with the shoulder. It's not coming forward. And that elbow is staying up, but the shoulder is staying down. Feel free to adjust the length of your tube or band if you need to. And if you're using a weight, you can adjust the weight that you're using. If it gets too heavy, just put it down. If you feel like it's not heavy enough, pick up a heavier one. How about two more? Last one. Good job. Lower both arms down. Ooh, shake out that arm. Roll the shoulder forward. Roll it back. When those muscles get tired, they get really kind of stiff and tight, and we don't want them to stay that way. So make sure that you're loosening them up however you need to. All right, and we're going to switch sides. So now my right elbow is staying down and my left elbow is coming up, and I'm going to go out and in. Out and in. Out, and I'm keeping my left arm straight out in line with the rest of my body. When I go out, my palm is facing forward. When I come back in, it's facing the front of my chest. Try not to let that arm drop. You can do it. Three more. Three. Keep that elbow up. Last time. Good job. Lower the arms down. Ooh, roll your shoulders forward. Roll them back. Good job. All right, we're going to take that tube or band and we're going to step on it with both feet. Okay, we're going to leave the upper body alone for a few minutes. So we're going to work the backs of the legs and the glutes, the muscles in our chest. So we're going to shorten up the tube a little bit or the band, and then put your hands against the sides of your legs. Make sure that your feet are at least hip distance apart, maybe even a little bit wider. If you'd like to, feel free to stand in front of your chair. I'm always trying to make my feet even. They never want to be exactly even. Okay. And then abs in tight, shoulders back and down. We're going to push back, stand up. Make sure that your hands are not moving or they're moving as little as possible, pushing back into your heels. When you come forward, you're looking down at the floor, not out in front of you. Abs are in tight, supporting the low back. Really push back into your heels. And make sure that you're inhaling on the way back up. And push back and stand up. And push back and really feel that in the backs of your legs. Stand up, give it an extra little squeeze when you stand up. Extra little squeeze. extra little squeeze. How about two more, please and thank you. One more time. Good work, everyone. All right, bring those feet together a little bit. Make an X. Switch the handles for the end. Take the feet wide apart again. Put your hands at the front of your legs. Even if you have, if you're using weights and not a tube or a band, put them on the front of your legs, right? And then squeeze back. So we're squeezing the shoulders. We're pinching the shoulder blades. Keep squeezing. Now squeeze back and hold and relax. Squeeze back and hold and relax. Let's do that one more time. Squeeze back and hold and relax. Good work. All right. Now bring your feet all the way in so they're touching, right? If you can, leave the X in your tube or band. And then bring your hands to the outsides of your hips. So even if you don't have the X, pull your hands up here. And if you have weights, again, here or maybe even down here a little bit if you're not using a tube or a band. Okay, starting with the right leg, out and in three times, and then the left leg. Here we go. Out, in. Shoulders stay over the hips and left. Out, in. Toes point forward and right. Out, in, out, in, out, in, and left, out, in, out. So try to squeeze your shoulder blades now, right? Out, pull those abs in tight. And left, out, in, out, in, out. Now right, out, in, out, in. Good, and left. Out, ooh, it's just getting fun. Try not to quit. And right, we'll make this the last one for three. And left, three, two. Now alternate, right and in, left and in, right and in, left and in, right and in, left and in, right, left, right, who are we feeling these yet? Last time, each side. Good job. Woo! Release. If you have an X, undo it, right? And make sure that your tube or band feels the same on both sides. Sometimes it gets a little bit uneven. Ugh. And then take the feet apart, bring your hands back behind you. Try to pull, if you have a handle, bring it up to your palm. So if you have weights, try to hold them more in your palms and your fingers and relax your fingers as much as you can, and then press back, press back, press back, press back. Hold those shoulders back, press back. Abs are in tight. Four, three, two, one. Ooh, good job. Come on off the tube or band and set it aside. Roll your shoulders forward, roll them back, shake them out. Shake out your arms. I'm gonna grab another drink. I know what you're all thinking. Did she forget about the side of the waist? And I did not. We're just gonna do it differently today. Okay, So if you've gotten your drink, great. And then grab a lightweight, right? We're gonna go back to working the side hip, the side of the leg. If it's too much to do this with a weight, do it without, right? So what we're gonna do is, I'm showing you the seated version first. So you're gonna go like this. And the standing version is gonna look like this. So ideally we don't want that foot to touch the floor, but if you need for it to touch the floor because of your balance or your strength level, then do, okay? So either sit out toward the front of your chair, but over to one side, or stand behind your chair, right? And give yourself plenty of room to pick that leg up, although you're not picking it up very far. And abs in tight, here we go, up. Up. So it's only going maybe 12 inches, but no more than that. And again, try to keep the toes pointing forward, abs in tight. And quite honestly, you might feel this more in the leg you're standing on than the other leg. Now, luckily for those of you who are sitting and doing this, you're only going to feel it in the moving leg. Four, three, two, one, good job. So release and maybe swing the leg side to side a few times. And then we're gonna switch sides. Okay, so fingertips as light as you can make them, abs are in tight, make sure you're standing up tall. Try not to lean too much. Unless you're sitting, you might have to lean a little bit. And then here we go, up. So don't take your hand off the chair or the wall unless your balance is pretty good. So the upper body's not really moving. Abs in tight. We have four more. Four, three, two, one. Good work, everyone. Put that weight down. And face the back of the chair, swing the leg side to side, maybe four or five times, and then switch. Okay, and then we're gonna come right back here and standing a little bit away from the chair, we're gonna bring that outside leg around in front, around behind, around in front, around behind, around in front, around behind, around in front, around behind. Around in front, try to stay up nice and tall. If this is too much for you, just go back to that swinging the leg side to side. Make this the last one right here. Good job, and release, and then we're gonna switch sides. Okay, and around in front, around behind. 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 Around in front, good. Three, two, last time. Good job, and release. Good job, everyone. All right. Now, we're gonna go back to those light weights, okay? And we're going to start with the arms up here a little bit. Now, if this is too much for you with weights, then do it without weights. And I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do. So we're gonna pull the elbow down to the opposite knee or lift just the heel up, right? So if lifting up your whole leg is a little too much for you today, then don't do it, just lift that heel up. Okay, and we wanna try to stay nice and tall. So here we go, down. Make sure that you're really going opposite elbow toward that knee and take your time. So you're really going from side to side, 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 good, side to side, side to side. Good. Two more on each side. So this is one and two. Good job. Bring those hands down lower. Feet are out nice and wide, right? We're gonna turn, 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 knee lift. Turn, 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 knee lift or heel lift. Turn, 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 up. Turn, turn. So make sure you're really stopping to one side. Up, 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 up. Try to feel it in the sides of your waist and even in the front of your abdomen. Right, so abs are in tight, right? Try not to grip the weights too tightly if you're holding weights. Let's do each side one more time. Good job, and lower the arms down. Woo. Loosen up the shoulders again. Actually, let's go ahead and set these down. We're gonna leave our arms alone for a few minutes and we're gonna come back behind the chair. Right, so make sure that you're standing up tall, not out at an angle, right? And we're gonna put one leg back, abs in really tight, fingertips light on the chair, try not to use your thumbs, right? And we're gonna bring that heel up, down. So we're trying to keep that knee back, but stay upright. So we're not bobbing like that. Abs are in tight. Try to keep your chin tucked down a little bit. Now, lift and hold, 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 lower down. Lift and hold, 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 lower down. Lift and hold. Lower down, lift and hold. Lower down, let's do it two more times. Lift and hold. I know that other leg's getting tired. Lift and hold. Good job. Ooh, shake out your legs. Yeah, that was not so easy. All right, so get back into position, other leg. Abs in tight, shoulders relaxed. Here we go. Up, down. Try to keep that knee back behind the other leg, or at least no further forward than next to the other leg. Two more, and then we hold. Good. So we're gonna lift and hold, two, three, lower down. Lift and hold, two, three, lower down. Two more, lift and hold, two, three, lower down. Lift and hold, two, three, lower down. Good job. Step back away from the chair, but not too far because we wanna be able to bend the elbows. Push your hips back, bring your chest forward. Spine is nice and long. Breathe, pushing back into the heels. So really stretching the backs of the legs. Try to keep breathing. Good job. And abs in tight, inhale, stand up. Good work, everyone. All right, now, let's try this one first without any weight, and then we'll add weight. So we're gonna work one of the really small rotator cuff muscles on the back of the shoulder. So I want you to bring your elbows right here, so they're against your side, right, and under your shoulders, like this, right? And we're gonna palms up. We're going to rotate the elbows or the forearms out and back in, out and back in, out and back in. So really important to keep your elbows still and don't let them come off your sides. So when I was doing this exercise, when I was rehabbing my shoulder after shoulder surgery, they made me put a towel between my side and my arm. And that way, if my arm moved, the towel would fall and they would know I was cheating. So it's a really good way to learn how to not cheat at this exercise. But you should kind of feel this all over your shoulder. Do it one more time. Good, lower the arms down, roll your shoulders forward, roll them back. Good. Okay, now go ahead and pick up your lightest weights and we're gonna try it again. Okay, so again, elbows under the shoulders, right? Planted in against your side, palms up. Actually, palms can be this way too if palms up is uncomfortable for you for any reason. Okay, and then go out and in, out and in. So it feels a little bit different with weights if it's too much and it feels like it's impossible to do, or impossible to do with your elbows staying still, then put the weights down and do it without. Not such an easy one. But this works one of the really small rotator cuff muscles called the infraspinatus. Just do one more. Good job. And again, roll those shoulders forward. Roll them back. Good. And since we're already here, right, let's bring the arms down to your sides, palms facing the sides of your legs. And we're going to alternate lifting straight out to the side and then forward like this, palms in. Okay. So up tall, here we go. Side. Forward. So try not to go too fast, right? When we go too fast, we end up using momentum and then they don't ever get any stronger. So slower might be a little bit harder, possibly a lot harder sometimes, but it's much more effective for actually building the strength, right? So if your arms are starting to get tired or your shoulders are starting to get tired, so that you don't lose your form, it's okay to lighten up the weight or put the weight down entirely. Better that than that you end up doing them incorrectly and possibly risking injury. Let's try for two more sets. So nice and slow. Last time, nice and slow. Good work, everyone. Go ahead and set these weights down. Roll your shoulders forward, roll them back. Woo, shake them out. I'm gonna grab a quick drink. Right, and then we're gonna go back to working our legs. We're gonna stand up and sit down. Okay, so. Standing up and sitting down. Grab some weights if you would like. If you prefer not to use weights, that works too. Do what's right for you today. Right? So arms can be down by your sides or hands up on your shoulders. Right? If you're not using weights, try not to cross your elbows or your forearms like this, because that tends to make the shoulders roll forward a little bit. So try to put your hands on the front of your shoulders like this, or even on the sides of your shoulders, right? Feet are out at least as wide as the chair legs, whether you're sitting or standing. Abs are in really tight. Make sure your chair is where you think it is. And let's sit down, stand up. So we're sitting as lightly as we can. Abs are in tight. And if you need to push off with your hands, then push off with your hands. Try to keep your spine nice and tall. If this is uncomfortable on your knees or your legs, try repositioning them. And remember, if you get tired, then set the weights aside. If you're sitting and standing and not using weights and you're still getting tired, then just sit and alternate the knee lift. Right? If you're sitting and using weights and you get tired, set the weights aside and try to continue. And if you're not using weights, you might take a little breather, but try to rejoin us as quickly as you can. Let's see if we can do, let's do five more. So five, four, three, two, last time. Good job, everyone. Go ahead and set the weights down if you're using weights. Right, come behind your chair. Swing your legs. Right, if swinging the legs is too much for your balance, then sit down and hug them in this way with the hand on the front of the leg so that you're stretching the front of your leg. All right, now we're gonna go back to working the side of the waist. So we're gonna pick up one heavy weight, right, as heavy as you're comfortable with. And let's work the left side of the waist first. So hold that weight in your right hand, right? Left arm can be down by your side, fingertips on your shoulder or behind your ear. Right, feet are pretty close together. Okay, abs are in tight. Here we go. Down, up. Remember, those knees stay straight and the feet stay flat. The right heel wants to come up off the floor. But when it does that, then the left side of the waist doesn't have to work as hard. But we want it to work. We want it to get stronger. Abs in really tight. Don't forget to breathe. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Good job. If you want to set the weight down, otherwise reach that left arm up, push your hips over to the left and reach your arm over to the right. Try to keep that left shoulder back. Ooh, feel your left side stretching. Keep holding it. We have 10 seconds left in this stretch. Five. Abs in tight, inhale and release. And we're gonna switch sides. Okay, shoulders back and down. Pull those abs in tight. Here we go, right elbow. Down, down. Or right hand if your arm is by your side. Do remind yourself, abs in tight. Knees stay straight, feet stay flat. Six, good job everyone. Five, try not to speed up. Four, three, and remember after the last one right here, if you need to, set the weight down. Otherwise, reach that right arm up, push the hips to the right and flex over to the left. And we're holding this stretch for 30 seconds, which as we know, can seem like a really long time. Try to keep breathing, keep that right shoulder back. We're halfway through. Five seconds more. Ooh, feel that side stretching. Ah, Good job, and release. Go ahead and set the weight down. I'm going to grab another quick drink, and we're going to come behind the chair and do a little more stretching. Okay, so stand behind your chair, but not too far behind your chair, because we want the elbows to be able to bend here. Cross one leg in front of the other. Try to make sure you feel centered behind the chair. And then push your hips back, bring your chest forward. So you should feel like you could rest your chin or maybe your forehead on the chair back. Elbows are bent and pointing down toward the floor, not out to the sides. Whew. And push back into your heels. Breathe. So I have my left leg behind my right, my right leg behind my left. So I feel this more in my right leg. Good. Abs are in tight. Inhale, lift up. And we're going to switch sides. And push back. Good. And breathe and think happy thoughts. We're almost done. Good, and inhale, come up, good. And just step away from the chair a little bit. Take your feet apart a little bit. Just kind of turn from side to side and let your arms just swing. Swing, swing, swing. Good, let's just do it a couple more times. Good job. And then stand up nice and tall. So think about lifting the crown of your head up toward the ceiling and tuck your chin down and then push it back a little bit. And we're just going to turn side to side, side to side. So we want to keep that head nice and level. So we're not going up and over, just sliding along a ledge or a shelf. Side to side, side to side. Whew. Side to side, side to side. Good. Good job, and release. And go ahead and sit down at the front edge of your chair. Okay, let's see. We're going to take the right ankle and cross it over the left knee. So make sure that left leg is straight out in front of the hip. If you need to, extend the left leg. And if you need to, put your foot below the knee, right? And if you can, gently press down just above the left, the right knee, right? Sit up nice and tall. Try not to lean back. And breathe, and make sure your shoulders aren't way up here. Try to keep them relaxed. Good. Good. Now, see if you can slide that right knee over top of the left. And if you can't, just put your feet side by side. Sit up really tall and turn to the right. So your right hand is going to the chair seat behind you. The left hand is going to the outside of your right leg or hip. And try to get your shoulders to turn and breathe. Breathing is always helpful. Good, and release forward, uncross the legs, and then we're gonna switch. So left ankle over the right knee is straight out in front of the right hip. If you need to extend the right leg or put your ankle below the knee, right? And then see if you can gently press down on that left leg just above the knee. Try to sit up nice and tall, right? We're not leaning back. And we're breathing and relaxing. And if you can, you can flex the left foot a little bit. That makes the stretch, or makes you feel the stretch a little bit more. It makes the stretch a little deeper. Leaning forward makes the stretch a little deeper too. Good, so let's relax. And if you can, slide the left knee over top of the right, or again, put your feet side by side. Sit up nice and tall, turn to the left. Left hand goes to the chair behind you. Right leg to the out, right hand to the outside of the left leg. Sit up tall and turn and try to get your shoulders to turn, but not pinch up towards your ears. And breathe. Breathing is very helpful. Right, try to keep that chin tucked back a little bit. Don't let it push out in front of you. Good, and relax forward, uncross. Stay out at the front edge of the chair, slide over to the right side of the chair, hold on with the left hand, lower the right knee down, lift up as tall as you can. Right, so you feel that stretch in the front of the hip, the front of the thigh, and if you can, lean back just a tiny bit. Try to feel a little more of that stretch in the front of the hip, the front of the thigh. And if you spend a lot of time sitting, these muscles get really tight and they can really prohibit movement in the low back, which we don't really care for. We want that low back to be nice and mobile. Good, and breathe. Good job, and sit up and bring that foot forward and let's switch sides. Hold on, bring that leg back, sit up nice and tall. And if you can, lean back a little bit. So I put my toes down on the floor, but if you prefer to point the toes back behind you, that's fine too. Either way, it's really whatever's more comfortable for you. Just try to keep your spine nice and tall. And breathe. Good. Okay. And then sit up, bring that foot forward. Let's go ahead and stand up and push your palms out in front of you at about chest level, right? Like this. Drop your chin down and try to round your back, kind of push your spine out behind you. Try to keep those arms and shoulders down and feel that pull across your mid back. Ooh, it feels good. All right, and then inhale, try to reach the arms up overhead. If they don't want to go up overhead, just do what you can. Right, you can good. And then lower the arms down and take a shoulder roll or two forward. And then three or four shoulder rolls to the back. All right, and we are all done for today. Great job.